Now, there are so many options. You can first pick AD carries like Ashe or Sivir. You can first pick, in this situation here, well, you can go, if you're really trusting your Victor, you can first pick Victor right here. He has no hard counters in the mid lane as well. Or you just go for a comfort jungle pick like Elise. And I love watching Gilius on Elise. When he's active in the early game, I'll take it. That's the fourth option I was getting to, but damn it, they're about to show it.
Well, Schalke did this yesterday. First pick the trundle, flexed it. They can go top, they can go bottom. And it did very well for Schalke yesterday.
One of the really cool things when you pick trundle is you, in many ways, block out Sivir as an AD carry. If you can get Sivir yourself in the next rotation, you then also have a pick that is really good against Jhin. So by first picking trundle, you kind of, in a way, block out potentially two AD carries. I take, okay, you don't want to play Sivir now, so we're going to pick the Sivir. That means you don't want to play the Jhin now. By us picking the Sivir, due to the trundle coming in first, as he is a good counter to Sivir specifically. So if we see that from MrRalleZ, I think actually we have a really good setup where you might be pushing Rekkles on something like a Lucian instead, or the Ashe pick, which we obviously still like to see.
Yeah, the Ashe is a definite possibility. But for Fnatic, they've revealed their solo lanes already. Gnar and Azir early on. Gonna leave their jungle ADC and supports for later.
And Gragas is the best jungler against Azir specifically, but Gragas has a much weaker early game than Elise and rek'sai, these picks that can gank so effectively already from level 3. And Gilius is a jungler who does well when he can be active early on. So I think he's gonna stick to Elise or rek'sai, depending on what they want for the top lane. If they want a physical damage top laner, just go for the Elise. And I would love Sivir here.
I think
I'm so happy Schalke are following my train of thought here. I think this is really, really smart because Jhin is going to be tricky now to pick for Fnatic. So they're going to go Lucian or they're going to go Ashe as one of their two picks. I'm going to say Lucian.
All right, Lucian or Ashe. Lucian already locked in. Hover here on the Kindred for Spirit. Very quick lock-ins. Do you think the Elise in the jungle signals that Trundle will be going top more likely?
Not decided yet at all, but against Gnar, no. Gnar is really good against Trundle in the top lane, so it signals to me it's going to be support Trundle, and you go for something that can actually bully the Gnar a little bit. Irelia is banned in this game. Olaf used to be a pick that worked really well against Gnar.
Banned too.
Banned too as well, so that one is gone as well. We've seen Jax was the other one for Steve yesterday against Gnar. Can actually win that matchup as a Jax and really snowball out of control. So I think Schalke here, again, showing up with a very, very smart draft. I really like that Trundle first pick and kind of the riddle effect all the way down, and then also getting that Jax pick in the end. Vladimir is my only question mark here. I don't think he's as strong anymore, especially not into like Azir and Victor and these picks in mid lane, but he still has the potential to walk into these teamfights in the mid game
and do massive amounts of damage
and just like destroy the entire fight, but it often requires him to run Ghost and not teleport.
Currently sitting on teleport for Schalke. We'll find out how Fnatic round out their draft, but Schalke, do you think we're going to be looking at standard lanes and Gilius hoping to help Steve get ahead on this Jax matchup?
Well, if Fnatic locks in a range support here, they can really bully the 2v2 against Trundle. I think this is a good choice. Yesterday, it was the last pick, Braum. That was a really bad choice. This is much better with the range support.
Swap to Braum.
Why? Take the Nami here. So you put Schalke in a situation where if they take 2v2 lanes.
But Braum into Sivir equals good.
Well, Braum against Trundle equals bad. So
like, so is Braum into Sivir good, not as good as Braum into Trundle bad?
No, so Braum into Sivir is good in teamfights because you can obviously stop a lot of her damage for a few seconds. But I think right here, if you're Fnatic, instead, you want to try and put Schalke in a situation where Schalke doesn't want to take standard lanes. Put the Jax in a lane swap so he falls behind. In that specific lane swap, instead now, you actually force yourself to at least consider the swap. Like, Lucian Braum is going to be okay against Sivir Trundle. That's not an issue.
Right.
Gnar is going to be okay in the early levels against the Jax, not the issue either, but if you take standard lanes as Fnatic now, I feel like you kind of set up Schalke for their main win condition, which is getting this Jax rolling in the start of the game, like get him to Trinity Force and then close towards the second item. And in a standard lane setup with Elise as your jungler, you have a very good 2v2.
And the potential is there for Schalke to take control if they can execute, if they can get those ganks and find out whether or not they can thwart Fnatic's plans. Guys, jump on Twitter, hashtag S04win or hashtag FNCwin. Whoever you think is going to pick up the wins here. Fnatic currently tied at 24 points with Splice. If they get at least one, they will maintain control of second place. If they get three, they'll be closing in on G2 Esports. Standard lane's prediction, yes or no, what are you expecting, DeFishio?
I mean, it all depends right now on Fnatic. And if they want to try and play the 2v2 lane, they have Ignite on YellowStar, so that signals to me they do want to try and play the 2v2 lane. They want to see if they can use this Lucian Braum, jump on a Trundle or Sivir, who both have no like extra mobility, especially in the early levels before Sivir gets to ulti. You can camp that lane. You can obviously use your jungle pressure as well, and you can try and shut down Sivir in the early game. Sivir is not the strongest laner, definitely not against Braum as well. So definitely tools for Fnatic there if they want to play standard. Okay. But then I'm looking at Steve. I'm just looking at Steve. And this, he has a good matchup, and Steve has shown he's a good enough player, also on our Jax, to actually carry games.
So the thing that I really like about all of these options is it depends on the player's ability to execute.
Third time, Trevor.
Whether or not Gilius, whether or not Gilius can find those ganks to support Steve, whether or not YellowStar's Ignite Braum can actually find the plays.
Because like, YellowStar is all laning for laning phase here. Not having double exhaust in the late game versus Vladimir Jax.
Terrifying.
Who's going to dive into these late game team fights and can 2 to 3 shot your squishies. You could have run double exhaust here, gone for a lane swap, and been like, okay, we're going to be really strong team fights. Braum is a fantastic team fighter with exhaust as well to shut down the Jax and Vladimir in fights. But instead, Fnatic are opting towards the laning phase. They're saying we want to win the early game. Right here, and obviously you have to respect the fact that in the late game, a Vladimir Jax 1-3-1 is very effective from Schalke, so they want to strike early and try and shut it down.
Strike early, shut it down. That's the name of the game. Spirit has resolved his mouse issue. We're loading back up onto the Rift for Fnatic versus Schalke, and Fnatic already grouping themselves up to get some deep vision into Schalke's jungle.
And this is normally what we see when you want to swap specifically. Could also be Fnatic just taking the first tier 1 tower and then trying to opt into standard lanes after. Jax is very good level 1, 2, and 3, specifically. Well, make it 2 and 3. I can actually have some good traits against a mini gnar, but small details, micro things, big picture instead. We talked about Schalke 1-3-1-ing. They're running teleport on Vladimir. Normally it hurts my heart a little bit because I love Ghost so much on Vlad. So he's so good at diving in the backline. Now you rely on a TP flank. Yeah. Honestly, that's your way of getting to the backline as Vladimir now, but it gives him side lane control against an Azir who's never going to move there.
And secretly hoping that Mr. RalleZ on the hunt might help out as well. Sprattel and RalleZ going to walk over the ward. This is going to give some information to Fnatic, but there's a bunch of pings on Fnatic's side of the jungle as well.
And look at Fnatic's movement here. They're also on a ward, so both teams are spotting each other. As soon as Fnatic saw Schalke moving towards topside, Fnatic instantly went topside with the Lucian and Braum. They're like, oh, we want this 2v2. Then they sort of move back again, and they're also moving back, so we get the 2v2 in bottom lane. Rekkles might be slightly delayed. This is important for the first push. If Rekkles loses 2 or 3 of these melee minions, he actually falls behind an experience. He lost all 3 of them.
Yep.
Now he's in lane. RalleZ, let's see how much he managed to pick up. He moved in. He's now already above 50% experience, and Rekkles is only on about 10-15%. Big swing for Schalke. They will get early level 2 and their AD carry. Meaning they can push down Fnatic now.
A lot of pressure then on Rekkles and YellowStar. See if they can bounce their way back. Sprattel and RalleZ pushing forward. There's that level 2 as RalleZ continues to step forward. Infernal Drake will be the first dragon of the game. So that could also add additional complexity to any mistakes being additionally punished.
And sadly for Schalke, because they had to push their wave to get their level 2, they got Fnatic all the way on the tower. Now is where you can try and zone off Rekkles, but he's gonna get level 2 on this minion here. And then it doesn't matter anyway. Well, one more minion then.
Yeah. Close enough. The wave
quick
together
math
in the
head went horribly wrong there. I'm like, oh, there's many minions.
All right, so Fnatic under a little bit of pressure in that bottom lane.
Well, it's even out now. So we get our standard lanes. Fnatic know that now they have a good chance to either camp the bottom lane with the rek'sai and have the Ignite on Braum, set up some kills, or protect Kikis on top side and try and punish the Jack if he ever goes aggressive.
All right, so that's the top lane. Currently, Kikis is shoving this one in. Steve at level 3, got to deal with farming, so not able to really contest Kikis.
It's fine, those are Jacks here. You just take the farm.
I feel like if you looked in that middle lane as well, Febiven was shoving Fox in. So for the time being, I think the pro players might use the term lane priority. A little bit more options for Fnatic in the opening minutes, especially when you consider how easy it is for Febiven to keep the pressure on Fox.
Definitely so. Gotta keep in mind, Vladimir is still a strong laner despite some of the nerfs, just not as good as he used to be. Will still be an even matchup, and Schalke have normally put a lot of focus on trying to snowball the mid lane. Like Gilius often talked about, if he gets an early gank in mid lane, Schalke becomes almost unstoppable. Not been the case the last few weeks.
I mean, correct me if I'm wrong, but weren't
like
you also
flying down and
weren't you also talking about
way
this yesterday on post-game lobby about how Schalke as a team rely kind of get Fox ahead, let Fox win for us?
Right, and it's a little bit too simple, right? It works in the start when every team is really weak macro, but then when teams get better and better during the split, that kind of strategy is no longer as strong, and that's where Schalke as a team got to evolve. And I think taking down Fnatic would be a big step. I just think Fnatic, after what they showed yesterday, are going to be the favorites. And Spirit, he didn't see anything.
I don't think he was looking at his screen.
Blind Gilius as a rat.
Fancy is a chance. Red buff is available. Here comes Sprattel. Flash is already used by Spirit to get away. Now Sprattel's a little bit out of position. And Spirit, I think, not looking at his screen is the only reasoning I can think for that one.
Well, Sprattel trying to see if he could either interrupt the tunnel, if that was on cooldown. Then if you could actually push Spirit a bit to the left, so when he flashed, he would flash into the wall instead. Again, a trade in the mid lane and a gank. This is the gank we talk about from Schalke. We see it so often.
Flash cocoon,
that
not going to connect.
Optimistic.
Slide and glide from Febiven.
You can only do that if you know Azir's dash is on cooldown. Otherwise, he's just going to be like, okay, I'm just going to dash out.
So miscommunication between Gilius and Fox? Maybe not talking about the
Or Gilius is being too impatient.
Okay.
Which I know is a big criticism when it comes to Schalke and Gilius specifically. Oftentimes being a little bit too eager when it comes to setting up plays.
He's been a player that has made and broken games for Schalke. He's single-handedly won them, and he's also single-handedly cost the team games. It is a very harsh criticism, but I think in some ways it is also true.
He's a 10-0 or 0-10 player in many ways, and this is actually why I still stand by this now fairly old statement of Schalke kind of living and dying by Gilius. But I mean it in a sense that Gilius can hurt his team so much that they end up dying. And if he's actually just playing with the team, not trying to do anything over-aggressive, following the calls, he can make Schalke live. He can actually make Schalke win games just by following them and allowing his laners to carry. Gilius doesn't need to carry for Schalke to win.
Yeah, Schalke's definitely got players capable of doing that, especially with Steven Fox here in summer. But I wanted to mention that Spirit, Gilius' opposite number, very early sidestone. Not even upgraded his jungle item just yet. Going to be placing a bunch of wards. Continues to farm up as, again, Fnatic playing fairly aggressive. They're shoving these waves in quite frequently every time we look down. Fox doing what he can to push back.
But they're not getting any advantage. So we always got to look at the fact that YellowStar is not having exhaust for late game. Looking at the fact that Jax will become this unstoppable monster in the side lane that a gnar cannot deal with. Gnar needs to get into team fights. Good little trade here from Steve, and then it's all about the return damage on the way out. But it's going to be all about team fighting for Fnatic in this game. They're not going to win a split push war against double TP with Azir. It's all about Fnatic team fighting well. Mess up in one team fight, and because your lanes are now even in farm, Schalke suddenly can snowball out of control.
See, I really like that narrative. I really like when you when you look at a game and it's
No, he's farming. He's farming, guys.
Just farming.
Effective farming.
When you look at a game and you can quite clearly see how the comps will interact with one another at different stages of the game, Gilius showed his face middle for an optimistic gank, but neither lane has really gone to the top just yet. Kikis or Steve just continue to trade back and forth. And interestingly, I think because of Sprattel's back timing, even though he interrupted YellowStar, I feel like he's donated an Infernal Drake, revealing his backed away.
Yeah, but this was gonna happen almost no matter what. Because Fnatic have the stronger, or had the pressure, sorry, in the 2v2-1 bottom side, naturally you will push it in, and then you will get an early dragon for yourself. This is one of the reasons Fnatic were looking for that 2v2, specifically. So good early start for them when it comes to getting a dragon. but still not getting much of a CS advantage. 68 farm on Ajax already.
That's worrying.
We're just going to keep tracking it, because what Schalke will do in the mid game is they're going to move the Vladimir to the bottom lane, and they're going to keep the Ajax sitting on top lane. They'll obviously split them up and move them around if they want, but they're going to have these two guys in the side lanes, and Fnatic can only play mid lane. They can only use Azir's lane priority and his push in mid to shove it down to mid tower every single time and put pressure that way. Otherwise, Schalke gets to set up the side lane. It's still effective for Fnatic if they can do it.
Yeah.
It's only RalleZ to wave clear.
Oh.
And that's where Braum, keep in mind, Braum can stop Sivir wave clear pretty effectively. So if Fnatic are in control mid, push it down, put Braum in front of the minion wave, push it into tower, you can siege that tower fairly effective. It's gonna happen later.
Yeah, we're 10 minutes into the game, almost. And very, very even. Fnatic, they got themselves a dragon, thanks to the sort of back timing between Sprattel and RalleZ down bottom, but Rekkles is now taking a lot of damage. Sprattel on this trundle, just pushing on the front line over and over. And YellowStar's only got so many shields.
Absolutely love trundle against Braum. Because whenever Braum goes all in, trundle runs at your AD carry instead. Steve taking another trade here.
Yeah, Grandmaster's might thrown down as well. Leaps forward, Kikis hops away. Good damage coming out of Steve.
And a fairly slow early game. Both junglers not been too active. We had a Gilius gank in mid that was very optimistic. Cost him a flash, obviously slowed him down quite a bit. And Spirit has just been power farming as much as possible.
Yeah, Merc trade's now picked up, by the way. Still just sitting on the machete. Slightly different pathing than what I'm used to seeing. But he's keeping up in CS with Gilius.
So we've seen it before when it comes to early sidestone. I also see Tiamat rush quite often, especially in the LCK.
Yeah. The boots are a little weird, though.
Well, let's see. CC on Schalke. Stun from Jax, Cocoon from Elise, which are the two things he's targeting. And also, a lot of magic damage early, even from the Jax, actually some bonus magic damage coming in. And then from Elise, from Vladimir. It is different. I can see the reason behind it, for sure.
When the eventual skirmishes break out, that's when he'll find out whether or not it will be impactful. Gilius, Runic Echoes completed. Negatron Cloaks for both mid laners. Although Fox has already picked himself up those Lucy boots.
And because the early game is so slow now, both teams get to set up so much defensive vision. So whenever you see these ganks coming in from Gilius, it's spotted. Like super far away. They saw him move in towards the enemy jungle down near the Raptor camp already, and they're like, all right, he's coming top. Easy, just path out.
And that's where Spirit to invade.
Yeah, then suddenly Spirit can invade, and then you get a small advantage. Yeah, you get a Raptor camp. Go you. He's a party hat, and that's it.
Yeah, but that party hat is equating to a 1,000 gold lead. You know, plus 20 CS in the top lane for Fnatic, minus 10 in the mid lane, minus 10 in the ADC.
The big thing is going to be these mid-game fights. If Fnatic are able to team fight, get a good Mech and R ulti down, they're going to win these fights. And that's what they need. The 1,000 gold lead now is nice. It's great. You take it. You take the Infernal Drake as well. But they're definitely looking for more.
So teleports and Mega Nars. That's what I'm looking for Kikis. For Schalke, on the other hand, because we've talked a lot about what Fnatic have to do, how does Schalke get themselves into this? Gilius farming his way up into power. They obviously want to play that side lane you mentioned.
Yeah.
But at what point or at what item break point does MrRalleZ get the tap on the shoulder to say, hey buddy, you're a mid laner now?
Once we get one item completed for the Vladimir, you can start moving him to the side lane. He's used already the first TP back to lane, so second one can be saved now. The problem is because Fnatic are pushing down mid lane every time, it's really hard to make the swap. Because whenever you then make the swap, you need RalleZ to already be mid and then catch the wave on bottom side. And then the second problem is because all tier 1 towers are here, the lanes are so short, it's very hard to set up 1-3-1. They can TP gank on bottom side, potentially on the side of Fnatic.
Ooh, flash from Gilius. Respect out of that one. A bite lands onto Gilius. Flash forward from Spirit. Repel comes up. Teleport's coming down from the top laners. First blood is available for somebody to take. Glacial Fisher thrown down by YellowStar. Sprattel gets stunned up. He's forced to flash away defensively. Fnatic see bringing red health bars in their wake. Febiven's coming down.
And Vladimir still sitting mid lane. It's 4.5 seconds on his teleport. Kick is getting Meganar very soon. Schalke realizing the Meganar is too scary, and they decide to back away, allowing Fnatic to get a bit of damage on this tower. Good little play from Fnatic. I really like Rekkles' positioning in that fight. He managed to single out MrRalleZ, and when a Lucian finds a Sivir, it's always a one-sided fight in favor of the Lucian.
And that allows Fnatic to get positioned in the lane, take the tower. And I think some credit to Schalke, respecting the potential engage even under the tower. They made it out, but advantage Fnatic.
Yeah, and we have to question, Gilius getting caught there in the river. Was it the right move for him to path into the river and try and contest some sort of vision? Not sure if it was a rift scuttler. Or did he move in at a time where Schalke couldn't actually assist him? Because that's always the key thing as a jungler. If your laners are pushed down towards the turrets, you can never move into the river. Like, you're always at risk. You can never invade into the enemy jungle. Because then the enemy jungler can just jump you and their laners will collapse. He ended up having to flash out. Fnatic knew they could keep chasing because they want a team fight. Fnatic are the team here who wants to play as five. So they get a bot lane tower for it. No kills.
Yeah, and Fnatic got the opportunity to play as five. Febiven roamed, kick his TP down. It allows Fnatic to extend that gold lead ever so slightly. Vision battle is now ongoing around the Ocean Drake, which is now spawned.
Interesting first choice on a Vladimir Abyssal Scepter against just Azir.
Not going side lane then?
He should still be going side lane with his teleport. The only other way for Schalke to play side lane is by keeping Sivir and Trundle in the side lane. But the Lucian, Braum, especially in longer lanes, are able to have the pressure there. As we've seen all game long, Fnatic be more than fine in the bottom lane. So that kind of removes the global advantage for Schalke in that case, which is really weird. I think Abyssal Scepter is not a great item to rush. It's a very defensive item now. It also delays your Spirit Visage.
Yeah.
If you then go Spirit Visage as your second item, you have a ton of MR, but you have very low damage. And then you delay your Rylai's, which was supposed to be your second item.
And you've somehow got to deal with a gnar Lucian rek'sai as well, with all that MR. Without any additional survivability, it's a challenge.
So I think he might just go Rylai's now as second item and skip the Spirit Visage.
Till later,
which definitely hurts his overall sustain. But gives him a bit more DPS because he has the Abyssal with the Rylai's. Interesting choices, something I haven't seen very often.
And I guess we have to measure its effectiveness once we see the second item completed. I mean, we're 16 minutes in. That single tower has fallen because Fnatic kind of punished Gilius's positioning. And when you look at the minimap, Spirit's done pretty well in terms of tunnels. Got good presence across the map. Febiven's able to secure the blue buff as Gilius is being a little optimistic.
I want to see Schalke use a TP play here, though. If Febiven returns to mid lane, perma shove the bottom side with the Sivir, and then you have Vladimir TP. Your jungler moves in behind the tower, puts down a ward. Vladimir TP's on the ward, and you 4v2 or 4v3 dive on that tower. You are late enough into the game, you can execute that. Otherwise, Schalke just forced Fnatic to step away from the tower and just take it down for free. Because we haven't seen that second TP used yet. Kikis has been pushing top lane all game long. He has a Rift held now as well, which is massive.
Makes Steve's life even more challenging.
Yeah, this is huge. Like, Rift held is actually such an important buff in this meta, where there's so many of these split pushing top laners, because it really, really turns the tide of the battle. And also Frozen Mallet build. So Kikis are building purely for the 1v1 at the moment. And it's been paying off for Fnatic. He's been doing well.
Well, that 20-minute timer is actually a pretty good summary for this team composition from Fnatic as well. Yes, they've got some great headroom and possibilities, but at some point, this Jax will outscale this gnar.
But if it's in 15, 20 minutes, Fnatic doesn't really care.
Yeah.
Because by then, they should have had two or three big team fights around a Dragon and around a Baron, and should have used that to get the advantage and win. Febiven has not been in any trouble in this mid lane.
No.
Like, he's like, I don't care about your Abyssal Scepter.
even the single lonely gank didn't do a whole lot. Kikis fancies a shot here at Steve. He's going to gnar him up against the wall, throws a boulder. He's going to get stunned up under the tower. Still got 1,000 hit points to play with. Steve's in trouble. A hop should be available. Not even needed. Kikis makes up for the earlier blunder.
Well,
first blood to Fnatic.
If you are a Fnatic fan, then you can definitely not complain about your new top laner. It's been a marked improvement over what you had before. Three games now for Kikis on Fnatic. Multiple solo kills already.
Oh, yes.
Here's punishing a Steve. Just outplaying him.
Yeah, really, really well played. DeFisher, Fnatic coming into this game were 11-1 in victories when they secured first blood. Of the 12 games...
That's why they picked up Kikis.
Hey, there you go. First blood. It'll give them a greater chance statistically as we cut to a live shot here of Kikis. Also, by the way, slightly obscure stats that don't actually mean a whole lot, but Fnatic have never lost a game to Trundle in summer. They're 6-0 versus Trundle.
So Trundle before this week was also 0-6 in the EU LCS. Trundle top,
top, okay.
Was a 0-6 in the EU LCS.
Was it a trap card?
A little bit. I think Trundle struggles a lot against control mages like Azir, like Victor. It's really hard for Trundle to actually get close enough to them. So when it comes to team fighting, Trundle is not the strongest compared to other picks. I think gnar, like a good mega gnar, is fantastic in these fights. And Kikis have been doing great up in the top lane. Fnatic have been winning the mid lane all game long. I'm still looking at this Abyssal Scepter, and the value behind it has been absolutely nothing. And you have had your TP Vladimir now sit mid all game long, and now he might die.
Take a look at this. Sanguine Pool will buy some time for Fox to escape. Spirit's now in trouble. Glacial Fissure very well placed from YellowStar. That allows Spirit to get out with the Cocoon connecting. No follow-up damage from Schalke and Fnatic. This has just been a very, very clean game. We're 20 minutes in. Fnatic have legitimately farmed a 3,500 gold lead.
And they're farming everything. Farming towers, dragons, minions.
Even got a kill.
Enemy jungle camps, they're farming champions. They're getting everything right now, and they've not really been under pressure from Schalke. Despite being down at global, Schalke have not used it to try and set up anything in the side lane. They've not been using it to win the mid lane either. It's just there. Taunting me, because it could have been a ghost, which would have meant your late game team fighting would be really, really good. Anyway, doesn't matter. I wonder what the plan is for Schalke, because I thought this Vladimir would have been side lane a few minutes ago. Now he's here. Now we get the 1-3-1, but your mid tower is almost dead. So playing 1-3-1 from behind is close to impossible, because it is purely built around you having stronger laners, especially in one of the side lanes. Like, you need one side lane winning and you need mid lane winning to execute 1-3-1 properly. Azir is really good at keeping champions like Sivir down in the mid lane and just constantly pushing into tower, meaning you don't win the mid lane right now. And top lane wise, Kikis has been destroying Steve. You now have your Vladimir with TP. That is your winning lane as Schalke.
Outclassed in nearly every lane on the side of Schalke. I caught a glimpse there of all three Schalke members just running towards Baron, but as soon as they got to Skullcrab, instantly turned around. I mean, do you think that was a just scouting it? Or
maybe
is now a desperation Baron play really what Schalke are looking at?
I mean, we see a lot of early Barons in Europe. It's something teams do a lot in scrims, and that's why they do it on stage as well. Obviously, used to having more gold as well from scrims, but I want to see if YellowStar on this Ignite again. Obviously, one of the big things about it is it can reduce the healing of the Vladimir.
Yeah.
So for late game fights, I still prefer Exhaust. Just I prefer reducing the damage instead. Because late game, you're going to kill him anyway with the Zia Lucian. But I can see the logic behind it.
Yeah, you're going to kill him. Slow him down from killing you.
Now, what does give an advantage to Fnatic is in the side lane. Because when you play 1-4 comps like Fnatic are playing now, it always actually becomes like the 1-1-3 compositions, where the 3 is the AD carry support and jungle on one side of the map, keeping down the enemy split pusher, in this case the Vladimir. So that's where the Ignite is going to be massive for Fnatic. But this is the siege on mid. We talk about Azir. We're always at lane priority versus Sivir. Just going to push it in 24-7. And that's a free tower. So 3 towers to 0, 2 dragons to 0, 1 kill to 0. It is getting quite scary if you're Schalke.
I think we're well beyond quite scary. I think this is terrifying.
Yeah.
I mean, that gold deficit, Randian's Omen and Frozen Mallet already for Kikis. A little bit of thrift shopping for Febiven, Needlessly Large Rod, Negatron, Amp Tone, double items Rekkles. To be fair.
To be fair, he's actually right now dressing like a wizard. Like, he has his big staff, he has the cloak as well. Has some boots on, and he has I'm going to call it a small dagger as well.
Yeah.
You never know when you need a small dagger.
I mean, it's called Nash's Tooth.
And
I know Nash is a big guy, but
he has a book as well with his staff and his ring. Perfect build. He understands what he needs.
That is the first time that an item build actually looks quite legitimate.
Yeah, it makes sense.
Not like a sword and a gun on somebody who throws boomerangs.
You never shot a gun with a sword in it?
No.
Pretty effective.
Okay. I'll take your word for it.
back in the days, you know, with the Vikings. Used to duel with axes, except they didn't have guns.
That's the thing, right? Because Danish Vikings would have done that.
They would have done it. If they were still here, they would have done it.
Yeah.
100%. But sadly, the Danish Vikings and the Nordic Vikings...
Deficio, by the way, feels very strongly about Danish Vikings. Like, this is not a joke nor a troll. We've had many, many discussions about how impressive Danish Vikings truly were.
They were.
And if you see him in the halls or anything, please ask him about some of the knowledge, especially about how they invaded and conquered the British Isles.
Which they did.
And you see he's getting like really worked up about this.
Sadly, they did not adapt to the meta.
Okay.
And then, as in League of Legends, as in real life, you will fall behind. So when they decided to start invading into France as well, they realized that they're a little kind of lame chainmail and axe on a sword, and it wasn't that effective against a knight on a massive horse in full plate armor, charging at him and just like smacking straight into them.
It wasn't really fair. It
was pretty effective.
It
so
wasn't really fair.
Kids at home, first of all, if you see a knight in full plate armor, do not charge him.
Okay, lesson number one.
Do not charge him. Second of all, adapt to the meta. Do it at home, do it in pro play. Casting meta as well keeps evolving and adapting.
It does. Learning about Danish Vikings is a thing that we need to do now.
I didn't teach you anything right there about Danish Vikings.
But you did
destroy England.
No, but you really did. That was a great little moment. This was not a great moment here for Schalke. They're trying to desperately make a play. Kikis is coming up from behind. No Mega Gnar though. He's going to need some time to build this up. Spirits fancying a shot. Kikis throws out the boomerang, hops over a spiderling, manages to get to safety.
The mini Gnar flank, not proving too effective.
Not really surprised by that.
Not too surprised.
Kikis should have stopped on the way and charged up that rage bar on maybe a camp.
On a raptor camp or a rift scuttler.
Yeah. That's
basically what the rift scuttler is good for. Gonna be third dragon for Fnatic. It is slow and steady, wins the race. This is a Vladimir running in a replay. And that happened. They're clapping for the dragon, Trevor, not the replay.
Okay. I mean, he's got Rylai's now, so maybe it's a highlight. The observers are just following this itemization build here.
And they decided to remove the items during the replay and just show us the Vladimir. Thanks, observers.
We'll add that to VOD review, because I think there's some questions we need answered there. But yeah, Fnatic, they're just...
Maybe they wanted to see his ass. Maybe that was it. Because he was actually almost zooming in on the back when he was running away.
Yeah, could be. But hey, each their own, right? Everyone's got their own preferences.
Sure. He's wearing the cloak though, so kind of hides him.
Production confirms that was not the case. Thank you, production.
Ah, okay.
Baron has been started here by Fnatic. It's down to 2,500 Fnatic. Peel away. Sprattel's the target. The Mega Gnar will throw Schalke around. First kill of the fight not secured just yet because it's Fnatic going down. Gilius rappelled up. He survived long enough to stay alive. And Fnatic donates 3 kills to Schalke.
So Fnatic started the Baron. They thought they could rush it down before Schalke could react. TP came in from Steve, everyone from Schalke just collapsed. That's gonna be mid tower as well. They just completely turned the game. Fnatic were doing so well, they were in full control. They never gave Schalke a chance.
And just like the Danish Vikings, Fnatic overextended.
Ah, every time.
Very serious face there from Daylor.
But this time it was against a blood magic mage and a guy wearing a samurai hat or whatever it is. I'm not even sure where the hat is from Jax. Anyway, sorry, it's not the Baron here. Okay.
Kikis not there either.
So they allow Schalke now to actually walk in, open up the fight. Let's see what happens in the fight. Misses ulti on Febiven, so that is huge. But now Sprattel goes down early. Rekkles with some nice little dodging as well. It doesn't matter though, because Steve gets to jump him and kill him. It actually looked pretty bad in the start. Like very, very start. But then Sprattel even stayed alive despite dropping so low on this trundle. One team fight from Schalke. Mid lane tower going down.
Gilius and Fox, Rappel and Sanguine Pool bought so much time. It just... targeting them down allowed Steve to get some wiggle room.
Wiggle room.
6,000 gold lead has shrunk completely. We're getting to 30 minutes.
Shrunk.
Yeah. Blade of the Rune King picked up. Trinity Force picked up.
And we shiver running down.
Yes, because Steve is becoming terrifying.
Steve?
Damn it, sorry.
There it is.
Shh, don't do that. But this is a threat now, because if Steve continues to grow, if he starts to get tanky now, which he will,
Fnatic's opportunity to keep him down. Tank. I'm not going to call Jax tanky.
Going forward.
He's obviously not... He's not going to shine normally in the team fight, but he just managed to shine just before. Impressive fight from Schalke. Fnatic getting punished for otherwise a very traditional Fnatic play.
Yeah.
They're Baron a little bit out of nowhere, trying to rush it down before the other team reacts, but Schalke were quick enough. They're still behind. 3,000 gold. So it's by no means in favor of Schalke. They have decided to move the Vladimir to side lane now, but they have TP advantage. Like, right now, Schalke, you should just push up mid. Push up mid and walk into Baron instead of Vision. Because Fnatic should not be able to fight you due to you having TP.
Febiven doesn't want that to happen.
They take
uses
so much
passive
damage
on the disc. And on the tower rather than Schalke, unable to push in.
Yeah, but when you push it in there, and Azir put up the tower, you move into the river. And you just clear out the blue wards, the pink wards, because Fnatic can't fight you. You have TP advantage. Problem is, they took so much poke damage from Febi here. And now that you see here, Niffy's writing it down. Or he's writing down stuff about Danish Vikings, I'm not sure.
Is this an unclear example of Schalke maybe misunderstanding or not executing the fundamentals? You know, there are some things that they're doing in terms of their team comp that could be done so much more effectively. So,
I think Schalke said, push mid. They saw the Azir turret come up and they saw Sprattel get chunked down to 40% and said, okay, let's just go back, reset.
Played safe.
And that was basically it. Now they're in the river because they still have the same situation where Kikis doesn't have TP for about 30 seconds. Once it's ready though, Fnatic can start to react to be a little bit more aggressive as Azir can start pushing out that mid lane. Steve is finding YellowStar.
Yeah, Steve and Kikis, the TP timers are about the same. Infernal's up in a minute and a half. That'll be the last regular dragon before Elder and Baron will be up, still up because it wasn't taken. So a potential objective to battle over. And we just have this kind of like a Baron vision dance going on as both teams are just skirting around the pits.
But now that Vladimir is sitting bot lane, remember when he doesn't have Ghost, he needs a ward behind the enemy team to get a proper flank and get into the back line, which is the all important thing as a Vladimir. You're not here to kill tanks, you're here to kill and dive in for the squishies. Right now, if you look past the river, there is zero wards placed by Schalke. So they are by no means in a position to like force a fight. Because all they can do is run at the Azir in mid lane, and then yeah. Azir is going to destroy you. So Schalke need to push in one lane as the four-man group, or the three-man group in mid, and then let these two side lanes push up at the same time. But Kikis has been so strong all game long, he's just been able to hold his one lane. And Schalke has not been able to get deep vision. Now there's one ward here. This ward could be important. If there's a fight around Infernal Drake, that one ward could win the entire game for Schalke.
See which direction Fnatic go. They're grouping up towards middle. Kikis with TP available. He's up 50 CS over Steve. Spirit Visage completed as well. Steve now got some HP and some armor to work with. Infernal Drake's the objective. The ward that Fnatic are just walking past. This is the one that DeFicio highlighted.
This can be the TP ward for Schalke. They gotta use it though.
On the hunt's thrown down. Schalke looking for it. There's the teleport coming in. Fnatic are trying to peel away. Rekkles is exhausted. Steve looking
Five
for the counter strike. He's exhausted. Fox is coming in from behind. Sanguine pull on Fnatic. The gnar is used offensively. Fnatic are routed. Kikis throws the boulder toss in. Connects with the chimney. Schalke lose one. It's a one for one. Sprattel's flash forward. Pin Febiven against the wall. Ralls cleans him up. Gets a double. Kikis is running for his life. And Schalke win the fight.
That was such a good TP flank from the Vladimir. Schalke got so much damage down before Fnatic had to retreat. And then turn around. Fnatic stayed. Re-engaged from Schalke. Two kills picked up by RalleZ. That's going to be Baron. And as we talked about much earlier on in this game, the scaling on Schalke is very scary. Yes, yeah. They fell behind. It looked good for Fnatic. But one big mistake, the Baron before, gave Schalke a way to get back in this game. They took it, won that fight, took a mid tower, even out the goal now with another one team fight. And it's all about that ward being placed behind Fnatic because it allowed the Vladimir to reach the back line. He TP's in. It looks risky at first if you're Schalke, it's only 3v5. Steve isn't here yet. Now the Vladimir joins, and it's going to be so much better. Look at this. He goes in, gets a massive ulti down, but sadly not able to chase any further. Even got knocked away by Kiki's ulti, actually saved more members. And then Fnatic stays around here. Great cocoon from Kikis from Gilius. That's a great mix of Gilius and Elise. Gilisi.
Nah, I'm pushing that too hard.
It's Gilis now.
Look at that damage.
There's an Aurelia in the game. You only did 900 damage. Sucky Aurelia.
I'm going to trust the numbers are right, the graphics are wrong. But Sprattel gets dropped down.
What?
Just out of position. Didn't quite see the setup. Yep. Moving towards the Baron pit.
Simply out of position. And Fnatic picks up a kill. Buys a lot of time now. Where Schalke are not able to use the Baron buff.
Close that gold gap. Steve, teleport is available. Going to move down to that bottom lane. As you mentioned, Fisher, Baron buff going to be wearing off slowly but surely.
It's funny though, because every single time you say Steve, I think of my old vocal coach called Steve.
He was a character.
He was quite a character. What a man. Definitely used to be like a bit of a playboy. every time, like 60 years old, came in with open shirts and everything. Great guy. Great guy. And now there's another Steve on screen.
Hey, look, he did a good job. He's helped shrink that potato, as
you said earlier. Yes, yes. It's all about shrinking the potato.
But the Baron siege is on for Schalke. They have the buff on a few of their members. Fox was in the mid lane. He doesn't have teleport for probably another 35, 45 seconds. And instead, Schalke just going to peel around, use this big minion wave. There is minions pushing towards Schalke top, though. So Fnatic will have some options if they can defend, if they can hold out.
Well, again, just buying time. Not looking to fight, just buy time. Buy time. It's all you care about. Just give a bit more time for Schalke to scale up the Vlad and Jax. Kikis still able to be very annoying. Such a massive turnaround, though, with these two fights. One of them, Fnatic, obviously set up themselves by starting Baron, but then another one, a good setup from Schalke. It's still 4 dragons to 0. So, like, if Fnatic gets an Elder Drake, it's party time. If Schalke gets an Elder Drake, it's kind of like, yeah, we denied it, go us, woo! And that's about it. Like, it's going to be so weak for them.
Yeah, not going to give anywhere near the same benefit.
And that just means, like, you don't have that as, like, a new win condition, specifically. Because otherwise, if you get an Elder Drake with 4 dragons, you can push it down so effectively with that Elder Drake buff, and you can often almost destroy objectives and win every team fight. Won't exactly be the same benefits from Schalke, but it's been honestly a fairly slow game. It's been a game where it's a lot about pushing, and just saying, Schalke, you can't do anything because you push down in like 2 or 3 lanes at the same time. Which means we're going to get these big, big, all-important fights.
It's also very interesting to see just how controlled Fnatic were and how one bad decision or one bad call, you know, not peeling away from Baron earlier, maybe not playing that situation greatly, undoes 25 to 30 minutes of good work. Because Fnatic were absolutely in control of everything. And Schalke, they got that window of opportunity and they took it.
And now Schalke is again playing these two side lanes with TP. Look at Steve at the bottom, man. He should just rush for that tower straight away. Fnatic doing the same. And the reason Fnatic can always get something in side lanes is because they always push mid first. They push in the mid, they can roam through the enemy jungle, take another tower, nothing Schalke can do to defend. Steve is trying to take a top tower. He could ignore Kikis, and he decides to not ignore him and just take the tower down. But it's all small things now, small trades back and forth, which in the end will become one big team fight.
Schalke's in the lead now, plus 700 gold. Considering they were down 6K, that gold graph will be quite a swing. Fnatic, a minute and a half till Elder Drake, starting to push in that direction, starting to group up. Obviously, this was also to deal with the pressure that was coming from both mid and bottom lane. And I like seeing Fox now going top. All of Schalke gets some of Fnatic's attention down in the bottom half of the map, and Fox is going to apply pressure up top.
Yeah, and just keep pushing bot lane if you're Steve here. You want that wave towards the Fnatic base, so someone has to go back and deal with it, or suddenly a Jax is sitting at your inhib turret. They're going in mid lane, though.
Oh, Sprattel's in trouble. He's already down. Fnatic pull the trigger, and they're looking for more. Gilius goes up, comes down, repels, flashes away. Ralls was chunked out.
Sprattel dying with flash available. Got caught out against just a Braum passive, and then instantly Rek'sai jumps him. This is massive for Fnatic. The entire setup from Schalke now. falling apart. They had the side lanes pushing in. They were ready to TP flank, and then Sprattel gets caught with flash. And now Kikis.
Oh, he's in trouble. Doesn't find the gnar. Forced to flash away. Steve jumps out. Hemo Plague is out. The four-man Schalke looking to defend against the five Fnatic members.
And these are the small individual mistakes that for a team like Schalke, who's been losing and losing and losing for 3 weeks, can suddenly mean that you, instead of winning this game and at least get a tie against Fnatic, who looked fantastic yesterday, you might end up just losing everything. And we gotta remind people, Schalke are down fighting to avoid relegation at the moment.
We'll talk about the points in a moment. Steve is teleported in. Steve is running. It was Kikis that teleported in. Elder Dragon's down to 3,500. Steve's alone. Gonna use the Elder to taxi away. Leaps over the wall. Down to 3,500.
But you need these members behind Fnatic. You need the TP behind. Gilius is caught in the Dragon Pit as well. The Vladimir and Jax won't have really high impact in a fight if they have to run at Fnatic. They need to be able to flank.
40 minutes on the clock, 10 seconds to Baron. Elder completely reset, and Fnatic have no globals.
It's all about getting deep ult here if you're Schalke. Well, catching out Spirit helps. There's a ward now where Gilius is. There could be a ward to use for Schalke here. It's very hard for them otherwise to reach that back line. Starting Baron means you're now collapsed. You're grouped at the Baron pit, and Fnatic can see everything, allowing Fnatic to get a much easier setup for a fight.
All right, information then going to be crucial for what could be the game-winning team fight. A clean moment. Now, I mentioned no global. Spirit's got that Void Rush, but he's with the team right now.
Big wave in the bottom lane here. Azir is running from base as well. Baron started. Spirit has to steal it.
He's going in. Spirit's looking for ball. Steals it! Fnatic get the Baron! Spirit loses his life, but Schalke, they made the same gamble that Fnatic did.
They have to get the Elder Drake now, but Fnatic are looking to fight. There are only four members from Fnatic.
There's no Mega Gnar for Kikis. He's in trouble. Steve's only got 1,000 hit points. Glacial Fissure will slow things down. Fox forced to Sanguine Pool. No Hourglass. The Sand Soldiers go forward. Look at that heal from the Hemo Plague. Steve will get run down by four as Rekkles is able to back away. One for one in the fights.
Well, Steve's going to die as
Steve
well.
Steve will go down.
Fnatic are so confident in their team fight with this Azir and Lucian when they can see Schalke on the map. So 4v5, they didn't care. They moved forward. They took the fight, landed some great damage again from these soldiers of Febiven, and they stopped Schalke from at least getting an Elder Drake. Suddenly, Fnatic gets everything. Schalke had TP advantage and yet decided to rush a Baron as 5. They could have set up that map, they could have played the side lanes versus no teleport from Fnatic. Instead, rushing in for Baron, take the 50-50, lose the 50-50, and now they can see all 5 members. There's no flanking from Schalke. The Vladimir without Ghost in this case is very weak. Look at the damage from Febiven. Like, get off my lawn here and just.
Wow, that
smacks
heal was
down.
A single transfusion. I thought it was Hemo Plague. Looking at the build from Fox, no Spirit Visage at all. He's gone pure AP. But, eventually, Fnatic take him down. Look at that. Death Cap, Rylai's Void Staff, Hourglass on the way. We'll discuss whether or not we like that in a minute or two. For now,
it's not even about the build now for him. It's about the fact that he can't get to the back line. There's no wards behind Fnatic at the moment. You have no ghosts. You can only run at people. And then Febiven will win team fights for Fnatic. Febiven has had a good game on this Azir.
Fnatic have just gone through Schalke's base like a hot knife through butter. Those towers lost a couple of seconds, even without minions nearby. Just getting dropped down. Kikis eats a cocoon. That really does matter. And here comes a very large minion wave. The Mega Gnar from Kikis will dissuade Schalke from engaging.
But you now have 2 inhibs down.
Yeah.
If you are a Fnatic, you've been winning team fights. You know that the only way Schalke can win is 2 TPs behind you. So every time you move forward, you make sure you have your double sweeper, you have 1 ping. You should have 1 ping in your support. YellowStar deciding to get an item instead, the Warden's Mail. I actually would prefer just double pink, but I think he's looking at it as there's one last team fight to win. So I'm going to have a bit of extra armor. But if you are Fnatic, it's all about just understanding where the wards are from Schalke. And this is where Schalke needs to hide wards in their own jungle. So to have that TP location for Steven and the Vladimir, just hide them in base, have home guards, TP on those two wards. YellowStar sadly is going to spot them, and they didn't hide anything. So suddenly, you're going to run at the Azir, who's sitting on five items.
Five items.
Have fun.
Plus, Baron's still there. Elder's worn off, I believe, and Schalke have got one inhibitor left to defend. Steve is doing what he can to shove out that bottom wave, but it's only going to buy a few seconds of time. And Fnatic, in the first game of the series, there's still another one to play.
Yeah, it's a TP flank. Good.
Flash forward into Cocoon, Emperor's Divide to buy time. Steve's looking for a target. Rekkles and Febby are side by side. A three-man stun. Rekkles is going to get away with his life. Steve runs him down. That's two kills for Schalke. The vision was available, and Schalke pounce, taking down Fnatic.
So I stand corrected. Schalke actually found a ward position here in their top lane, and it got their teleport off. Like, it's so fun to see how Schalke literally can only win fights when they get to TP in to the back line, and they managed to hide that one ward in lane where Fnatic didn't expect it. Around the corner as well, so Pinkbot wouldn't have spotted it, and far enough away from the bush to the side, so Pinkbot there wouldn't have spotted it either. Actually, just a very smart location for that ward.
The problem is you can only make that play every 5 minutes, and they're going to need another one of those into a Baron before they can regain control.
This was a confidence booster.
Okay.
Like, hey, we can win a fight. Great. All right. Can Fnatic stop doing anything for 5 minutes? Then we can win another fight. I don't think Fnatic will stop doing anything for 5 minutes. I think Fnatic will look to still use this double inhib pressure. And basically say, you have no teleports now.
Yes.
So now Kikis we get does. That open fight where we can see you.
Elder Dragon went down at about 41 and a half minutes, so that'll be coming up within the next 2.5. Baron shortly before that. So Baron will be up, there we go, 2 minutes away, and about 3 minutes away from Elder. Fnatic are going to have all the time in the world.
Yeah, but Fnatic, in my opinion, should just return to top lane. Make the exact same play, but this time don't be afraid of teleports. Push it in, use your super minions in bot lane and mid lane. Whenever Schalke sends someone back to defend, you move forward and get a few hits on tower, and you chip it down. So I think this is the correct play from Fnatic. Because absolute worst case, you don't take the tower, but then you still have vision and control to go Baron.
Right.
Because you're already playing topside. So this is good. No TP from Fnatic. Oh, sorry, no TP from Schalke. They have to just try and wave clear.
Time to set up the siege. Kikis takes a lot of damage, actually.
It's hard on one lane, though. It's really hard on one lane. Yeah. I think Fnatic instead,
especially against Sivir,
are using it to also just wait for Baron to spawn.
Control the Western Quadrant, get the vision down. Looking at wards, not along the inventory because we're reaching 6 items. Steve with no TP, keep that in mind. His teleport is just under 2 minutes away. Fnatic are going to have the ability to make a play much quicker than Schalke can respond.
Right, and we just saw in that last fight as well, one of the issues of not having like potentially double exhaust when both Jax and Vladimir jumps in and they're both targets you want to exhaust down. YellowStar have not been able to really use his offensive summoner at all in this game. Obviously give a bit of pressure here and there. It's also about mentally you're like, oh, I know he has that summoner, so I should not, you know, engage in a fight. But let's see in another fight. A few minutes and then we have actually just 1 minute, I think, for Schalke and they have the TPs. And then we're back. Look at these wards from Schalke really far behind on your minimap. In case they manage to push back Fnatic there, they know they can TP to them. One of them is disappearing now. Both of them are actually disappearing. Gilius should place another one.
There's still a pink ward way at the top of the river, though. If Fnatic decides
they're too far away, though.
Stall this out. Schalke, they're buying time. Inhibitors are respawning. The bottom one's just come up for Schalke. So if they can deal with these last waves of minions, they've reset the game and they've opened up the map once more. TP's going to be available for Fox. Steve is a little bit away.
Steve is a little bit away, and also Schalke is standing here in front of Fnatic. You can't really just start challenging a teleport right in front of them.
Yeah.
They know exactly what is happening then. So pink ward behind still. There's a big wave in bottom lane, but they can clear it out with TP available as well. Really, really critical moment here. If Schalke gets a proper flank, they can still win the fight and win the game.
One more team fight. I asked you 50 minutes ago to vote on Twitter who you thought would win. We'll ask the same question. Who will win the defining team fight? Fnatic pull the trigger. They're starting Baron. Fox is channeling the teleport to the pink ward we talked about in Gilius. He's chunked out. The Winter's bike comes down. No one else is on Baron. Fnatic peeled away. Spirit didn't get it. It's stolen. Schalke pick it up in the ensuing teamfight. Rekkles is killed. Spirit was left alone in the pit. It's a double kill. Four MrRalleZ as Fnatic are destroyed. The super minions are doing work in the bottom of your picture, but Schalke may have just won the game.
Yeah, Schalke learned how to team up with this composition here. TP in from the Vladimir takes down Rekkles with a few crits coming in from RalleZ. The amount of AoE damage from Schalke in this composition is insane in the late game when you get these severe crits. Take the Baron as well. No minions just yet. Might still be able to just tank the tower and take it down. They're missing the Jax at this point, so that was a little bit too much. Use the Spiderlings, man. Sacrifice them.
Steve's got a teleport if he wants to use it. 30 seconds. I feel like this should just be the game. Crazier things have happened in the European LCS, but for Schalke, it's looking convincing. Steve is just rocked up. Kikis gets caught by the cocoon. Mega gnar will allow him to buy just a few seconds of time. We'll be able to transform. Throws out the boulder toss. The Nexus turrets are going down. The Nexus is being focused. It's being dropped down. Fnatic will not respawn. And Schalke come from behind to pick up game one.
Yeah, what a turnaround from Schalke. It looked